If you want to put a 351 Windsor in your Mustang or other classic Ford, and you want to run fuel injection, the only OEM option is the Cobra Lightning intake, and people are getting ridiculous amounts of money for those. I wished there was a cheaper option.
It's too bad we couldn't figure out a way to connect this upper to this lower so it would work.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
So the 351 Windsor, or 5.8, already sits about a half an inch taller than a 302 5.0. That can be a pretty important half inch when it comes to hood clearance. With this intake compared to that intake, it's no wonder that no one's ever going to be able to easily get this under the hood of their classic car. If only there was a way to take this upper intake manifold and mount it to this lower intake manifold. Then you could fit it in a hot rod and not have to spend the kind of money for lightning intakes. So the first thing you've got to be aware of that makes this DIY project possible is the port height. If you look at the height from here down to here, it's about an inch taller than the height from here down to here. That gives us room to create an adapter plate to go between the 5.0 upper and the 5.8 lower and still have correct hood clearance. The last thing that totally makes this DIY project possible is the pattern. This is the truck intake pattern. And this is the car intake pattern. And if you place them one on top of the other and line the holes up on this one end, you can see that that is fairly close. Is it perfect? No. Is it gonna flow as well as a Lightning? Probably not. But can we make an adapter that's gonna give us the clearance we need and have a lot of power without sacrificing too much power? I think we can. The rest of this video is going to be narration over the top of photographs because I wasn't shooting video at the time when I made this adapter. At the end of this video, we will have a reveal of how it all looks on the engine sitting on my engine run stand.
I started with a piece of aluminum bar stock, 4 inches wide, 18 inches long, and 3/4 inch thick. I could have used 1 inch thick material, but I figured if there was anything I could do to lower the upper intake ever so slightly, the better off that I would be. Ultimately, this is going in my 62 Galaxy, and there is not a lot of hood clearance. And since the 351 Windsor is about a half an inch taller than the 302 that's currently in there, I figured if I could shave a 1/4 inch, I would be ahead. Keep in mind that by going with a slightly thinner piece of aluminum, the transition between the intakes will not be as smooth. The next step was to lay the gaskets one at a time on top of the bar stock and trace the outside shape. I also took the opportunity to center punch the holes. These holes are going to be very important because that's going to allow me to trace the pattern onto the bottom once the holes are drilled through. Because what we're looking at here is the top of the adapter and the piece that will be connecting to the 5.0 upper, the pattern you see is that of the 5.0 upper. The red area, however, is the opening of the port that both the 5.0 upper and the truck lower share. Time to start drilling some holes. The two holes on the left are shared by both upper intakes. The four large holes that you see, the two in the middle and the two to the right, had to be drilled and countersunk because hex head cap screws go into those to connect the adapter to the truck lower. You can also see four smaller holes to the right, two in the middle that are slightly angled, and two all the way to the right. Those had to be drilled and tapped to accept 5/16 bolts to bolt the 5.0 upper to the adapter. I also marked the area that both intake patterns share in black because I wanted to put it in my drill press, and drill that black area out. After drilling out all the holes, including the area that I had marked in black, I flipped the adapter over and traced the truck pattern onto the bottom to make sure everything was still lining up correctly. From here, I was able to use a body saw and connect the holes in the ports that I had drilled to be able to remove those pieces and open each port up enough to be able to work it.
So this is what I use to open up the holes on my adapter. This is a carbide burr in just your basic pneumatic die grinder. One issue that I had when I was working it is the teeth kept getting clogged up with bits of aluminum. After talking to a couple of friends, they suggested I use automatic transmission fluid as a cutting fluid. And let me tell you what, made all the difference in the world. Even if there was bits of aluminum stuck in the carbide burr, a quick dip in ATF and then back to the workpiece, and the bits of aluminum would come right out of the teeth.
Here is the initial test fit after completely opening up the holes to match the ports for both the 5.0 upper and the 5.8 lower. Knowing that I had a good fit on both the upper and the lower, I once again traced the outside shape of both gaskets onto the piece of aluminum so that I could spend some time at the bandsaw cutting it out. The next two pictures show it mounted up, first to the truck lower, and second to the 5.0 upper. The important thing to note here is the amount of area that is a direct pass-through. Yes, having a slight jog in the runner is going to reduce flow a little bit, but there's enough area that is straight through, and this jog is not a real steep angle. So I really think the amount of airflow that is lost by using this adapter will be very, very minimal. For comparison, I have a complete 5.0 car upper and lower on the left, and the newly mated truck lower and car upper on the right with the adapter plate in between. And as you can see, they sit at about the same height, and they look about the same, other than the fact that the lower on the right is a little wider to accommodate the wider width of the intake on a 351. With the adapter in place, this 5.0 upper looks right at home on this 5.8 lower. And if you didn't know any better, you would think that this is how the setup came from the factory.
So there we have it, a 5.0 upper. What? Yes, that's a Tremec box, and there's a TKX in that, but that's a different video. As I was saying, this is a 5.0 upper intake manifold from a car mounted onto a truck lower EFI intake manifold. Again, will it perform as well as the Lightning? Probably not. Will it perform as well as the expensive aftermarket EFI intakes for a 351? Absolutely not. Will it perform well enough for my application for me to be happy with it? I think so.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.